Three wolves and a moon. Like the first run, I did feel like my race run, so I know when I come into a track like that, I always have a good weekend, and I know I had fun riding the track. The track's sick, and I thought the middle bit would be a bit gay, but it's real fast and flowy, so I know the whole track's fun, and yeah, I think the rain made it good too, so yeah, it's fun. Half of Weiss beer. It's damn nice. Well, as you can see, I'm drowning my sorrows. I rode alright, but I had a crash at the bottom of the steep bit near the finish. I don't know what place I finished yet, but I think I was in 20th when I came over the line, so as soon as I put that world champs jersey on, I fucking eat shit.
Made a little mistake at the top before like a pretty crucial flat section, but apart from that it went okay, apart from your mate over there reckons I was slow, but I've made a bit of a drastic dry tire choice, even though it's pissing down rain the whole time, but seems to be working out for me. I mean, underneath is like all gravelly, and I figured that a dry tire is going to be as grippy, if not better, on a route than a wet tire, and hopefully roll better on the big flat section, so we're sticking with them. I think I might be the only person in the whole of Austria right now with them on. Ultra Dead Mouse Promotions.
It's fast and it's super technical, and super pumped today because it's super wet.
I'm just gonna go out there, I'm gonna ride my best, and I'm just gonna, you know, ride the right lines and may the best man win.
Alright. I'm just gonna fist pump.
all over the show. I was bouncing out of ruts, taking lines I hadn't even seen were there. It was definitely hard. I mean, that was so gnarly. The ruts were so deep and conditions were just hard. And you know, it's, thanks to old Hattrick for getting my bike together and the rest of the crew. It really makes a difference when your bike's ready to go and feels as good as it was this weekend. It really was cool, but man, I tell you, that was tough.
I'm not gutted, but you know, not stoked either. It's second place, just behind Greg, 0.7 down. You know, would have been cool to win it, and I thought I was going for a bit, but to be honest, I was thinking Blinky was going to be a danger man, but now it's all good.
The Mega Avalanche here is the famous because there is lots of people. It's the longest downhill, so it's unique.
First time I've ridden dust in a long time, so it's pretty good. Don't really get much dust in Europe, so I know make the most of it. Like all the bottom there was because I caught the other group, so I was just passing riders the whole way down. I hit like a dude in his back wheel and he went off the bank and stuff, so I felt pretty bad. But apart from that, it was pretty fun though, passing heaps of people.
I don't get scared.
That's what he's trying to say. He's trying to act tough, but he isn't. He's soft.
Like the snow.
Gotta get my elbows up, make sure that the dude who's a 10-time world champ, just knock him out first corner, then there's some other Joey on the left. And then all I need to worry about is Brandon.
You've seen these lately. Look at that. Boom, boom. And that's only on safety at the minute as well.
I don't think I've recovered from the seeding run yet. I was putting quite a lot of effort and now I'm just knackered all the time. I need to go to sea level for a bit, I think.
It's kind of slashy, so you can still go fast, but you're not going to like die if you crash. So. I think we'll see at the bottom. More confident. Plus, I got to try to beat my wife's time, which is going to be near impossible.
First, I'm going to go straight and then feel how the snow is and then just do whatever automatically comes.